Move over, Arturo. There is another laser in the workshop. Hey everybody, my name is Sam and welcome back to Samcraft. In today's video, we're going to be taking a deep dive look and trial of the Genmitsu Jinsoku LE-1620 laser engraver sold by Sain Smart. Let's go. This laser engraver comes with all the standard things you would expect to find in a laser of this price point, model, and style. You get the laser itself, the control arms, a little bit of tools to put it together, and some sample material and cheap little laser glasses as well. I gotta say, assembly on this laser was hands down the easiest thing I've probably put together in my entire workshop. It literally was two screws to assemble the gantry arm, four screws to attach the laser, and then a couple of plugs and tiny little bit of cable management. That's it. Comparing it to other lasers out there on the market that want to say they're catering to the DIY crowd by making you assemble it, this was a joy to put together, super easy, and really felt nice. About the last thing I like to do whenever I get a tool is have to spend a lot of time assembling it, unless I got it at a super good deal, low discount, or I guess in the world of my CNC, knew that it couldn't just physically ship assembled. These small little diode lasers tend to be of one or two classes. One will be the good luck, put it together yourself group, and the other seem to be kind of like this one, where there is some assembly required, but really not that much. The instruction booklet that comes with this laser was perfect. It walks you through every bit of assembly, full color pages, perfect. I have zero complaints about that, and that was a great job by Sain Smart, or Genmitsu. Not sure who's doing what, but just keep doing what you're doing. Just finished doing the tile test, which honestly in my book is the number one thing anyone should ever do when they get a laser engraver and they want to find what is the best or optimal settings for engraving your surface. Now you want to do this on every single different material you plan on engraving on, so be willing to burn some stuff, literally waste through them, so you can find the correct settings. So looking at the tile test here, it's very interesting the results I get, mainly because as it got faster, it almost looks like the laser loses its focus. The faded edges or the areas that aren't really engraved are feathered, whereas in other tests that I've done, they kind of are more uniformed whether they're there or not. According with this, the ideal setting would be around 2000 millimeters per minute at 80%. There's a little bit of the differences between the Genmitsu and the Auteur. This is not a comparison video, so that's all I'm going to say about that. Stick around or let me know if you want to see the comparison. I'll go over that. Otherwise, check out those videos and check out this video and, you know, do the comparison in your head. I know I'm going to get asked the question, how thick of a piece of wood or material would that laser cut? And to that, I want to say, I'm not going to show you that. In my opinion, these are laser engravers. They are not cutters. Any kind of diode laser of this style, make, price range, whatever, is really not designed to cut material. Yes, it can be done, but honestly, it's not something I'll ever use in my workshop or use in a situation where I feel like it's worthwhile to show you. Because honestly, by the time you do all the labor or the time spent to run your machine to cut through items, I mean, realistically, nobody's really going to be doing that. At least, I'm not. I value my time more than that. So from that stance, I'm not going to show you anything other than just engraving, because that is 100% of the jobs I do with these machines. My auteur is worked all the time. My small business keeps us hopping for engraving, customization things, and it's perfect for that. This Genmitsu, another one, perfect for that kind of stuff. So I only ever consider laser engravers to just be engravers. I don't try and push them to the max to be cutters as well. I'm sure there's other videos out there, people showing you how to cut or how thick these machines will cut through things. So definitely check those out and search that out if it's really important to you. But that's my reasoning for why I don't include this in these kind of videos. As far as the capabilities of what can you engrave with this machine, it's the exact same stuff you can do with any other diode laser. Things such as glass tile, painted ceramic tiles or unpainted ceramic tiles, bamboo coasters, slate coasters, basically anything you can think of and anything that you're seeing other lasers, diode lasers, engraving. This machine will do it too. You're just gonna have to run through the tile test on the material to find out the settings to tweak them. Otherwise, this diode laser is the same technology that others are. So if they can do it, this machine can do it too. Just like I mounted the auteur laser on a board, I put the Genmitsu on a board as well. This is, I guess, my thing to do. I like it because it makes it portable and makes sure everything stays nice and solid, flat bases. I'm able to engrave a grid pattern on the bottom. In this case, you see the template, which is the rectangle is the cutting area or engraving area of the machine. I have room for 2 4-inch disc circles or coasters, and then I put a little grid system in there on 1-inch centers. I found that having the lasers mounted to a board is very beneficial for me in my shop. I like to move tools around. I may move one laser here, another there, hang one up on the wall, hang both up on the wall, and it just adds in the scale of portability without worrying about breaking some legs or losing functionality of the machines. I'm not doing anything super thick on engravings, but if I ever have to do something like that, I can always unmount these from their boards and use shims and blocks and fix it that way. But I don't foresee having any problems given the materials that I've worked with so far, the things that I've done, and what I can see on the horizon. So out of the box, assembled, handful of uses under my belt. What do I think of this little machine? I think it's awesome. I think it is a great deal, a great buy at the price. It comes with a lot of features that other lasers in my workshop didn't come with out of the box. Most notably is that tool-free vertical adjustment and focusing of the laser. That is awesome. It is smooth, it is tight, it has no slop in it, and is very, very good. In addition to that, having the button on the back of this machine to quick fire, you get your laser location, is very nice. You don't have to do the shift clicks and all that stuff in Lightworks. You can line it up that way with just the machine itself. I like the fact that the electronics are hidden behind at the back of the machine. They're not up front. There's not a big box that you have to fight with. This does mean you have to reach over to the back to turn it off and on or unplug it if something does go awry. But for this style laser and format, it works and it looks pretty good too. Whenever I first saw this style machine, I wondered how that arm floating out to the right side would work, whether it be good or bad or cause problems. And honestly, there's nothing to be said about it. It doesn't cause any problems at all. Laser engraving is a no-contact form of, I guess, subtractive machinery. It's not additive, so it's subtractive. Either way, the laser is not actually touching the products you're engraving, so it doesn't have to be 100% coplanar. Yes, you know, if you want to split hairs, if it moves up or down, you may lose focus here and there. But honestly, given the size that you're able to use with this machine, the workspace, you're not going to notice a difference. So overall, having the floating arm is pretty cool. It is very easy to load and unload materials. I mean, there's nothing in your way, hardly, and that's pretty cool. As far as things that I do not like about this laser, first and foremost, it is slow as molasses whenever it is homing. I know I can tweak that through some G-code settings within Lightworks to flash or format the board to tell it, okay, let's home a little bit faster. Other than that, the laser does not seem to be as powerful as another one in my shop that is labeled with the same outage or wattput. What? Wattage or output. Jeez. Call me spoiled by the first laser I got, but this one does not have any kind of built-in plastic shielding or protection between your eyes and that laser beam. So anytime it's on, you've got to wear your glasses. It would be nice if there was something like that added or included with this machine. That would be nice to have. And that's the only reason I say that is because the Auteur has it out of the box. So this one didn't have it. So I noticed the difference. Otherwise, this is a great little machine. It is a great starter. I think that it would do very well for anyone looking to just get their toes wet in the world of laser engraving. Remember, engraving only, not cutting. And is fully capable. Has just the same number of capabilities as the Auteur that I've used, but in a smaller form, smaller footprint, and a smaller price. So that is it for the first look. Well, it's not really a first look. I've used this thing for about a month. It is the Genmitsu Jinsoku LE-1620. I believe I said that right. It's a laser engraver sold by Sain Smart. There are links to this down below as far as other things as well. If you're interested, check it out. If you have any comments or questions about this laser engraver, other things in general, leave me a comment down below and I'll be happy to answer what I can. And if need be, make a video on that as well. Otherwise, appreciate you guys watching. Take care, and I'll see you next time in the workshop.